Okay, people, we are going to do a little bit of a quick and dirty video, I hope, because I'm doing some dinner. Linux is a cheap Unix. And before you go all crazy and get your tits all twisted and want to put your balls in a vice and yell and scream at me, please listen to me. And I'm talking not so much about you if you're a desktop user. I'm talking about what Linux started out as and what its main use is, because we are not the main users of Linux. It's the IT industry, it's corporations, it's servers, and so on and so on. So what do I mean by cheap Unix system? Well, Linux started out as a project because a really, really cheap drunk guy could not get or afford a Unix system. So he made his own Linux. And then a lot of people that used to support Unix, the GNU people, the users and stuff like that, they got their eyes up around this and, you know, they implemented a lot of the GNU tools on top of it. There's still a debate on if the GNU people did it by themselves first or if other people put GNU tools on top of Linux, but summa summarum is that Linux and GNU tools are kind of morphed in together, at least in the early 90s when it came around. They were like, we had Linux, the kernel, and then we have the GNU tools to make Linux basically usable. Nowadays, we can take some of those GNU tools out and replace them and stuff like that. Where were the GNU tools used before? Unix systems. The GNU tools was used primarily on Unix systems. Now we have Linux, where, you know, they saw this great project, and they were like, ooh, if we bundle this together, and this is what Richard Stallman is saying, is that they had basically an operating system. They missed the kernel or didn't have the kernel functioning available yet. They were working on it. Linux did a kernel. Let's morph them together to make an operating system, a Unix-like operating system. And that's what how he says it came around. I'm more in the camp of that he realized that a lot of people were starting to bundle the GNU tools with the Linux kernel. He was like, what's this little thing? And then he got his eyes opened. Again, we can debate this till the cows come home. But the fact is that the early days of Linux was basically the Linux kernel with a lot of Unix tools on top of it. Why a lot of things in Linux and in the Linux user land, basically Linux is the kernel and everything else is either GNU and other people's projects. Why other people's projects and the GNU is so similar to Unix, you know, how we do things under Unix, because they were working with Unix and supporting Unix and was meant for Unix in the original state. Then companies started to open their eyes about it. Why? Well, let's just pretend you want a file server or you want a web server. And for this, the use case that you wanted it, Unix is the best choice. But Unix is massively expensive. There is a massive amount of licenses fees tied to that. So they are like, oh, there's this Linux thing that do basically what we want out of Unix, but for free. Maybe some licenses, you know, some service agreement and stuff like that, but you also had that with Unix. So we can actually save money by using Linux, because it does kind of the same thing as Unix and even better in some instances, or as good in other instances as Unix. So we could throw out a lot of money for this Unix brand name, or we could use Linux with a lot of the same tools available for it as under Unix, you know, Apache and stuff like that. Yeah, let's go with Linux. And then they were like, oh, we need this for Linux, or oh, it was would be nice if Linux could do this. So they started to support Linux by giving code back, money back, and stuff like that. Why? Because it's still cheaper to do that than go and buy a licensed Unix system. Hey, Unix, IBM has Unix systems, and Oracle probably also have Unix systems. There's probably a proprietary Unix system out there right now. So that's what they, and why they're doing it right now, because Linux is giving the corporate world almost the same tool set, let me put it that way, as a Unix system does, but massively cheaper and sometimes better. And in worst case, same performance, same stability, same usability. And a lot of the systems, tools, programs that we already are used to use under Unix, most of them are under Linux. If not all of them now today is under Linux. So we're basically, what I'm thinking as like a company right now. So what we are doing is we're changing the kernel out, but we're giving the getting the same, and we are saving a shit ton of money on the Unix license and stuff like that, and what, you know, the amount of money that you was throwing out at Unix. So if you put it over to the desktop, a lot of people say, oh, you should use Linux because, you know, service agreements and licenses agreements will be cheaper. That's actually why a lot of companies are using Linux today. Those companies would have been running Unix before, so they switched from Unix to Linux because it's not like it's a different system than Unix. It's built upon a lot of the same principle of Unix, and like I said, a lot of the same programs run, again, if not all, runs under Linux that runs on a Unix. So for an end user, it's not that different. It's the kernel that's the difference. But for a company that, like, I can get the same tools, you know, I can use it for the same workload, and it's as good or better than Unix, and I don't have to pay for it. Or at least I don't have to pay the same amount of money as I do for a Unix system. Because, don't quote me on this, but I think running Unix was actually more expensive than running Microsoft Windows or Microsoft products back in the day. Because there was massive fees and licenses money and all of that fucking shit associated with Unix. Why BSD was kind of, FreeBSD was also kind of popular in these areas, because people that want FreeBSD is like, I could pay for Unix, or I can get this free FreeBSD that runs the same tools as Unix does, and it's better or as good as Unix. So therefore, it's massively cheaper for us to do that. That's why I sometimes call Linux a cheap Unix, because it replaced Unix when it became a little bit more mature. So what we actually want Linux to do on the desktop, replace Microsoft. Linux actually did on in the corporate world and server market with Unix. It's actually really fun to think about. The Windows versus Linux on server market is a little bit iffy, because Linux have some advantages that Unix didn't have, like the ecosystem, and Windows also have some advantages over Linux in like the administration. You know, it's easy to administrate, and Windows do some things better than Linux, weirdly enough, but Windows do some things better than Linux that is needed in the corporate world. If you think about it, if you go over to the desktop, you and I, we want Linux to, the general consensus is that Linux should replace Windows as the most used operating system for a lot of Linux nerds, okay? But Linux was built up to not even compete with Windows. It was built up to actually compete or be a replacement for Unix. So that means that from the early days, the focus was not Microsoft dominance. It was not, let's make something alternative to Microsoft. It was, let's make something alternative to Unix, you know, Solaris and HP Unix and all of those Unix systems. It was not designed to be a desktop replacement for Windows. It was designed to be a desktop replacement for Unix. Look at it like this. Making Linux, or want Linux to replace Windows, is a little bit like taking Gentoo Linux from scratch and making it newbie friendly. Can it be done? Yeah. It takes a shit ton of work though. But it can't be done. It's not easy, but it can't be done. Why? Because the average desktop users are not the target for Linux from scratch and Gentoo. Some will even say Arch or say Arch. You know, the everyday average consumer computer users are not the target for those distributions. So they are not designed from the ground up to cater to them what Windows is for and Mac OS is. Linux being a cheap Unix, as I call it once in a while to piss people off. Me, what I'm basically saying is that Linux was built, and to some extent still to this day, are built to be an alternative to FreeBSD and Unix, that then also happens to be an alternative to Microsoft and do things better than Windows in certain server areas and stuff like that. But that was never the main focus. It's kind of become it nowadays, but for the first many, many, many years, that was not really the focus, and definitely not on the desktop. Like, Linux was not even thinking about the desktop, I think, or Linus Torvalds was not even thinking about the desktop. He just wanted a Unix system to develop on. So you kind of have to look at the DNA of Linux. And what is the DNA of Linux? Well, the DNA of Linux is kind of like a clone, or not, don't take this literally, but it's like it wanted to be a clone of Unix. It wanted to do what Unix is doing. It didn't want to, or set out to be a desktop Microsoft competitor. It is now. Like we can... Many people can use Linux instead of Microsoft Windows today, but that was not the goal, and that was not the work that was put into Linux for many, 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 many years. See you all later. Bye-bye.